Namaskara ellarigu. With October being the Breast Cancer Awareness Month, I will take this opportunity to enlighten you on the topic of hormones and breast cancer. So first I would like to introduce to you how hormones play an important role in breast cancer per se. So when we say hormones and breast cancer, and particularly relating to estrogen and progesterone hormones, which are normally present in our body and have normal physiological roles to play as well. So in a normal breast tissue, there are receptors which respond to these hormones in the body. So when the receptors are abnormally present or abnormally stimulated, meaning to say when the levels of these hormones are abnormally high in our body, they can excessively stimulate the normal breast parenchymal cells to an increasing number. So when they start multiplying, some of these cells can also abnormally multiply, gain additional mutation and become cancerous cells as well. So in this context, hormones play an important role in the causation of breast cancer as well. So what are these scenarios which can cause excess of hormones in a woman's body? So one of the most common scenarios is endogenous excess hormone synthesis. So endogenous, when I say, these are situations where there is an excess internal production of hormones. So whenever a woman has an early menarche, that is, she starts to synthesize hormones from the ovary at a very early age level. So this poses a risk for breast cancer. Whenever a woman has a late menopause, meaning to say, for a prolonged period of time, this breast cells are exposed to increasing hormone production in the body. And nulliparity, that is, in a lifetime, if a woman does not conceive. So by meaning to conceive, what we say is, whenever a woman conceives, there is a break in the hormone production by the ovaries. So there is a decrease in the hormone levels in the body, which in turn is protective against breast cancer. So when a woman does not conceive in her lifetime, this poses an additional threat to breast cancer. And breastfeeding, of course, because all of us know, as long as a woman continues to breastfeed, there is something called lactational amenorrhea, or the ovaries cease to function as long as the woman continues to breastfeed. This happens in majority of women. So this again is protective, and when we do not feed, the ovaries regain their function quite early post-pregnancy, and this can in a long run pose a threat to breast cancer. The other endogenous hormone production which I would emphasize in this talk is obesity. So obesity is a silent killer, so also in a non-communicable disease like breast cancer, wherein the fat cells in excess can itself start producing hormones, and these hormones in itself can pose as a threat to breast cancer. So what are the exogenous sources of hormones? I covered endogenous. Exogenous is what is supplemented from outside. So sometimes women are used to taking these oral contraceptive pills, which are in fact a composition of low dose estrogen and progesterone supplements. A long-term intake of these OCPs are known to have a risk on breast cancer. There is something called hormone replacement therapy, which is given in postmenopausal women when they experience excessive postmenopausal side effects, and the doctor prescribes them some kind of hormone supplements. Even this in a long run can produce, especially if a patient is at risk for breast cancer, a chance to go to developing such breast cancer related events. And as I again mentioned to you, the obesity as a forerunner, which should always be in the back of the mind. So the next topic which I want to deal with respect to hormones and breast cancer is how hormones become an integral part in the treatment for breast cancer. So there are five different subtypes of breast cancer, and in that the commonest type is a hormone positive subset, wherein when we diagnose that kind of subset, it is those subsets wherein the breast tumor is positive for receptors for estrogen and progesterone, meaning to say any excess of these hormones in the body can cause either the causation or the recurrence of an individual who is diagnosed with breast cancer. So an integral part of treatment of such diagnosed breast cancer patients, that is hormone positive breast cancer individuals, involves anti-hormonal therapy. So in this anti-hormonal therapy, One of the most important treatments that we give is chemotherapy. The chemotherapy in itself can cause ovarian suppression and sometimes a kind of permanent medical menopause itself, especially in perimenopausal women. But again, post completion of chemotherapy, based on this hormone positivity and in this hormone positive subsets, we put them on additional anti-hormonal therapy. These are oral drugs like tamoxifen in premenopausal women and anastrozole or letrozole in postmenopausal women. These are given for a minimum period of 5 to 7 years basis on the recommendation of the treating medical oncologist. So again, to conclude my talk, what I would place as a relevance for hormones in breast cancer is lifestyle. Obesity plays a very important role in breast cancer. From our side, the endogenous hormones, our synthesis is not under our control. But what we can is exogenous synthesis and a lifestyle modification where we control our body weight and lead a healthy lifestyle. And again, to conclude my talk, I will take this opportunity to advise all the women in the age group between 40 to 45 years and above to pledge themselves for an annual mammogram starting from this year, every year, October every month, as a tribute to Breast Cancer Awareness Month.